How does this distract you or act tentatively around you? Now sit back and enjoy the show.
Oh! family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed. Who might that be?
We've sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Well, of course we have no bread.
What do you wish?
It's not what I wish. What you wish? Nothing cooking in that belly now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell Tumble that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a pig, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a lovely couple, but not the neighbors. You see, your mother was a child, and she took one look at my beautiful garden, and she told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, nothing but greens. Bring me these four things before the time of midnight in 3 days' time, and
I'm not coming, and that is fine. Now, what am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the silver as pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the silver is pure as gold.
And so the bakery left himself to meet the enchantress's demands. As for Cinderella,
I still wish she could go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk.
But how am I ever to get to the festival?
Tender and fresh, not one love. Take the count and go home.
I was trying to be
magic. Are we going to dispel this curse with deceit?
No one would have given them more for this creature. Besides, we did them a favor. At least we'll have some food.
5 beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in betweens. No one waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe there is really magic. Who knows? Why do you do what you do? That's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
She's crying.
If the union was pure and intent, if it's meant, and it's just a little bent, doesn't matter.
Yes.
No, what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. But of course, it really is the size. Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end is in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beans.
Thank you, pal. I will carry this on my own back.
And so the baker continued his search for the cave as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep in the forest. And when the old enchantress paid a visit, she called for him.
What is that red cloak on the side of me?
I will get that bread cooked from inside of your stomach!
Charming.
Yes, the prince.
He has charm for prince. the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high, below in the world, you've left in the things you know little more than a glance, that enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high, you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known. The sky is lead and the earth is stone. You're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you never dared, because you don't care when suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant.
Beautiful young maiden I danced the night with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared. like a fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I'm not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found a lovely maiden. She lives right here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes. On top of a tall tower that has no door or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mossy zone.
And how do you fit it?
I stand beneath the tower and say, Rapunzel! Rapunzel! Let down your head to me! And then she lowers the most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel! Rapunzel! What kind of a name is that? You jest. I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She is as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has.
Did I abuse her or show the disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond the power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. Blind tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her head. Blindly coming and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Agony, far more painful than yours. We know she'd go with you if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach?
Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
You are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why, oh,
girl must be mad. Of madness till you're climbing her hair and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her ah. I need a though it's different for each.
Always 10 steps behind, always 10 below, and she's just out of reach.
Yes! you do take plenty of spills now, don't you, miss?
These slippers, they're not suited for these surroundings. Actually, they're not much suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
Oh, yes. They are all you can wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give for just one.
One is not likely to do you much good.
Not with the ball, just as wonderful as the last few.
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes.
And they have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes.
Beyond the woods, beyond the winds, the slippers and the boots, just the two of us. goodness, look what this hen just brought to my hand.
A golden egg? I've never seen a golden egg before.
Yeah, I promised more than the 5 gold pieces I gave you, sir.
5 gold pieces?
I'll take my cow.
5 gold pieces?
Wait, I don't know what I was to sell the cow back.
I took the 5 gold pieces.
You took the 5 gold pieces?
I didn't take, he gave.
Where are the 5 gold pieces?
Well, an old man took them from me.
You would take money before a child?
Milky White is dead.
His wife buried the dead Milky White.
You must go back to the village and search another cow.
And what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here, tell them it's magic.
No person with a brain larger than this is going to exchange a cow for a bean.
Well, then steal it.
Steal it? Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising deceit and securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
I think it's best you go for the cow, as I have had a maiden these previous eves, and I think I can succeed in obtaining one of her slippers.
Fine.
Fine.
That is just...
Fine!
Unfortunately for Rapunzel,
no!
The witch discovered her affections for the prince before he could steer her away.
What did I clearly say? Children should listen.
No, no, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see.
No!
I don't know. Barbara.
My grave made it for me from a wolf that attacked us, and I got skinny and old myself. And best of all, she gave me this beautiful mind to check it.
Well, look what I got. I hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where did you get that egg?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giants, up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the beautiful golden harp the giant has. Plays the most beautiful tunes without even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll get that harp to see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise. And as he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes, blinding him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him. He spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares. And I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. At your soft
far off kingdom, my liege.
How dare you offer such without me?
I'm sorry, it's just, I thought—
Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse as we approached on the stairs, and there, when the maiden left, remained her shoe.
Brilliant!
That's what I thought. It did create quite a mess when the other guests left, though.
And Your Excellency, I have also succeeded in obtaining the veil.
Give them the slipper, and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you?
Oh, and first I fear I seem deleterious, but what—
Now, shut up!
Given what he wants, he's obviously a spirit of the wood of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes, sir.
As for the prince, he
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain, and joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride.
Look at the clown within the shoe. This one is not the right, that's true. And the first that fails.
The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on her shoe.
When you see-
upon a time. Lady.
I wish.
In that same far-off kingdom.
More than any.
Lived a young princess. Soft, the lad Jack.
More than footman.
I wish.
And the baker with his family.
No, I miss. I wish. More than anything.
More than love.
There. I wish to stop my best.
More than life.
I miss.
Tax and promise.
More than riches.
I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
I wish we had
another
route. But despite some minor inconveniences, they were all content.
I never thought I'd find a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I'd live in so.
Correct!
not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Look, Joshua, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can you do for me, sir?
I come to investigate the destruction that was wrought upon our house today.
Jack's been with me all day.
Baker told Jack and his mother that he feared there was a giant in the land.
Well, I can recognize Jack.
You'll do no such thing.
Any help at all.
I'm sorry, but you'll get none from us. I don't recall you volunteering to come to my aid.
Well, a giant in your backyard is one thing, a crush is almost quite another.
Listen, young man, giants never strike a sand mouse twice. I'm sure you'll be fine.
I'm taking this news to the castle nonetheless. When the baker reaches the castle, it was his princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Madam, this little man wishes to speak with you.
Princess, I've come to report the news of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see it.
Then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
Our house is destroyed and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait.
A nearby house was visited not long ago by another giant, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
And that giant was slain.
Princess, when he slept at home, he was very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance.
Are we through here?
Yes.
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going off to sell cargo.
Mother, no!
We don't want this cargo. There's a giant on the loose.
Mother, I know. Kill a giant.
We cut our bill of giants.
We feel just somewhere that I
can. Enough! Promise me you won't leave your surroundings.
Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. I want you to promise. Promise!
I promise.
House.
We've had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
We just frightened the young woman.
You can't frighten her.
I guess Granger will have to without the breakfast. Besides, I have all I can carry.
Why such a load?
Oh, I'm afraid of Granger. We had an accident too. I came home to find our house collapsed. I took a big window in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh no.
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Good morning.
Philip! What a surprise!
How good to see you.
What brings us to the wood?
I am investigating news of the giants.
You? Investigating news of a giant? Father would not even do that. That's business for your steward or less.
Well, what brings you into the wood today?
My Rapunzel run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She's been subject to a series of crime. Boots has no soul to predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell me what you were really doing here.
I am towered like yours was a tiger, a beauteous sleep. Oh, and the tower of thicket, a briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no restoration will keen, when the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside the casket, a maiden alas, just as unwakeable, what unmistakable agony is the way all is born. The skin went to snow.
Did you learn the name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, such as princes must weep. Always enthralled, most to anything, almost for something asleep. Not for the thicket,
a thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest,
the quickest, just pick it apart with the stick.
Yes, but even one prick is my thing about blood. Well, it's sick, it's no sicker than your maiden boy.
Fools are very upsetting.
Not forgetting the tasks unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable.
Outside.
Where is the lad who killed my husband?
haven't seen him.
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk.
We'll get him for you right away. Don't move.
It's you who destroyed her house, not some great wind. It's because of you I'm her mother.
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter, then he stole our gold, our men, and our cart. Then he killed my husband. I must admit the wrongdoings.
We are not responsible for him.
Well, you're wasting your breath.
She's right. I can't reason with a dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told you he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there, and I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
The giant, who was nearsighted and lost her glasses, remained convinced that she had found the lad. There is no consensus among them as to which course of action they should take.
Put the spell on her!
I have lost my powers!
If I didn't, do you think I'd be spending all my time here?
Then we have to give her some.
Who? No.
The steward. It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life!
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
I'm waiting.
You must understand. These were not people familiar with making choices. Their past experience in the woods had in no way prepared them to deal with the force this great.
Excuse me, but would you like a blind girl instead?
How dare you!
What about her misery?
We're not that miserable.
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
Fine! But what do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It is interesting to examine the moral issue of question here. The finality of situations such as these dictates. Excuse me one moment, please.
I'm sorry. I tell the story. I'm not a part of it.
That's right.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside. You see, that's my role. You must always have someone on the outside.
Well, you're going to be on the inside now.
You're making a mistake!
Nonsense!
You need an objective observer, someone that can pass your story along.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
Listen, if you drag me into this mess, you'll never know how your story ends. You'll be lost.
Wait, he's right. He's the only one that knows the story.
Well, do you think it'd be fun to tell yourselves? Just my point. Think of your baby.
Oh, no, stop it. He's right. Oh, put that away, young lady.
Well, now, we want to want to live in a world of chaos, wouldn't we? Now, you must always have an objective observer. Someone that
can... He is the one!
Why did you throw him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him, too.
Oh, we might have thought of something else.
Well, if it was up to you, a decision would never have been made.
Now that he's gone, we'll never know what happens next.
It's okay, we'll manage.
Must I search among you for the lad?
Jack, we won't. Promise you, you won't let any harm come to
return to normal.
We have to be off for a tour ride before nightfall.
Where are you going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
Shh!
We can't take everyone.
There is nowhere to hide.
You'll never get there. We have to stick together and figure this out.
Look, some people are cut out to battle giants, others are not. I don't have the constitution, and as long as I can be of no help, I'm going to hide. Everything will work out fine with you.
Not always.
I hope the giant steps on the mall.
You shouldn't say that.
You were thinking the same thing.
This is terrible. We just saw three people die.
Since when are you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same. Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop!
One step at a time. Maybe if the boy apologizes and makes amends, she'll see that he's a good boy at heart.
Yes, he'll return the stone.
You people are so blind! It is because of that boy that there is a giant in our midst. Now while you keep talking about the problem, I'll find the lad, and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Are we really going to let her feed the boy to the giant?
No.
I'll have to find him first.
I'll go with you.
No, stay with the baby.
No, we'll fan out and we'll increase our chances of finding him. And I want you to stay here with the baby.
And I don't want you roaming about the woods, do you understand?
You would leave her alone with our child?
Yes, the baby is safe with the girl.
And what if the giant were to return?
The giant will not harm them, I know this.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if?
But what if? What if? Will only a giant's foot stop your arguing? 100 paces. Go.
Yes.
Have you come upon the giant?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes.
And you would wander the woods alone?
Oh, well, my husband and I, it's a long story. 5 feet, 6 feet.
Your husband would let you roam the woods alone?
Oh, no, actually it was my choice.
Your choice? How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. Can I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. Oh, wait a moment, please. We can't do this. You have a princess.
Well, yes. I do.
And I have a baker.
You're right. How foolish. Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please. Any moment we could be crushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment. After all, see the moment, skies say no. Any moment. Wrong, don't chatter in the woods. Only feelings, let us meet the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, as you take the moment present, as a present for the moment.
Jack! One, two, three. Be of service.
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Oh, don't say that.
It's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure the prince will see to it that the giant be rid from our land.
He's probably out seducing some young maiden.
What?
I understand that's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You look like a princess, but dirty. Oh, my goodness, you're a princess.
Please get up, get up. I'm not a princess here.
What are you to do?
I must be on my way back to the castle.
You haven't heard. The castle has been set upon by the giant who came upon the royal family.
And the prince?
He wasn't with them. Come with us, you'll be safer in our company.
Solving over her like she was his own mother. How awful.
How could this happen?
Buried in a footprint.
I shouldn't have let her go alone. I should have stayed with her.
You must get nowhere.
My wife is dead.
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now we better get this boy to the giant before we're all so much dead. Keep away from him. This is no time to be soft-hearted. He is going to the giant, and I am taking him.
Yes, it's because of him that there's a giant in our midst, and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault I was given those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans, and without those beans, there'd have been no stock to get up to the giant's in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to when she told where they were. Those beans were they oversold, or tell us to persuade me to steal that gold.
It's your fault.
No. It's not true. Wait a minute, though. I only sold the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
Yes.
Kemp, those beans when our house was cursed. She may get a cow and get the curse reversed.
Alone.
stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path. Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes, maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Always from here.
But you said we had to find a way out of this together.
It doesn't matter whether we're together or apart.
We need your help.
You don't understand. It was my wife I helped. I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child.
My child would be happier in the arms of the princess.
Wait.
I thought you were dead. Not completely, are we ever? As far as I'm concerned, you are. Is that true? It's because of you that all this happened. I strayed into that garden to get your mother a gift. And I foolishly took some of those things for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? And when she died, I wrecked her for my guilt. And now, aren't you making the same mistake? No. Aren't you running away?
No more questions.
Please.
No more tests. Comes the day you say what for. Please. No more.
We disappoint, we disappear, we die, but we don't.
What?
They disappoint, in turn I fear, forgive, no they won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo. Left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more fears. Time to shut the door.
Running away, let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair, or burdens to bear, out there, in the yonder. Running away, go to it. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's a where, you'll only be wandering blind.
Happier day.
Simba.
He was a little baby?
It looked like he was going to.
Give me my son.
Now what are we to do?
We must have a plan before we defeat this giant.
What?
We all have to think.
There's just some way we can surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise. Oh, good friends! We need your help now more than ever! Watch out, the prince! I don't care. What's important now is we find a way to fell the giants. How can you help? You could do that? How can I ever thank you? You can talk to birds. The birds will help.
Bravo.
When the giant comes, they'll swarm her and peck out her eyes until she's blind.
What good will that do?
Then you can surprise her, strike her, or whatever you need to kill a giant.
Well, once she's blind, she'll stagger about.
She'll get angry.
And she'll crush us all.
We lure her to an area spirit of pitch.
Yes, her shoes will sit and she won't be able to move.
I can climb a tree and strike her from behind.
I will as well. It may take two mighty blows.
I'm going to kill the giant.
We must find some pitch before nightfall.
There's some at Granny's house.
This way. No, no. Stay here with the baby. He'll be safe with you. This will take no time. This way.
Went in that direction.
My darling, what are you doing here? In those old clothes and with a child? We must return to the castle at once if the giant comes.
The giant has been to the castle.
Oh no, are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love. Am I?
I love you. I do. But yes, it's true.
Why? If you loved me, would you have strayed?
A part of me thought that if you were mine, I would no longer want for more. And part of me is as happy and content as I've ever been. But there's still a part that continually needs more.
I have, on occasion, wanted more. But that doesn't mean I went in search of it. If this time you came as a prince, what kind of a king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. And I did not ask to be born king. I'm only human. I'm not perfect.
I think you should go.
Leave. But I do love you.
Consider that I have been lost, a victim of the giant.
That is what you truly wish.
My father's house was a nightmare. Yours was a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince. You see over there, between those tall trees? When the giant comes, we are to send her over there. Good. I want her to climb the tree, too. I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong? My granny's gone. No, I'm so sorry. I think my mother and my granny would be upset with me. Why? They said to always make them proud. Here I am about to kill somebody. Not somebody. A giant who has been doing harm. But the giant's a person. Aren't we to show forgiveness? Mother
Why would he do that?
He was afraid she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No.
That steward will pay for this. After we slay the giant, I'll slay him.
You'll do nothing of the kind.
You shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
I guess not.
He must die.
Well, no!
What he did was wrong. He should be punished.
He will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm going to kill him.
Then kill him. No, no, don't kill him.
Mother isn't here,
love. It was right.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear,
love. Things, fight things.
We were lost in trade.
You decide.
You are.
Back. They need first.
You got to finish first today. Maybe you'll wait tomorrow.
twins too?
You must return to the castle.
I'll gladly help you with your house. They're attached and actually jointly. How proud your wife has been.
How sad this is my son will ever know. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you're meant to have children.
But how do I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just one.
Wish.